Are you cold? I'm cold. It's 32 degrees here in Florida. This is ridiculous. This is a sunshine state. This is where oranges grow. This is where we get two seasons, hot and then super hot. Not hot, fall, cold, and then super cold, and then there's actually icy on the road a little bit, and then there's like this hot again. We don't get that. This is not what we subscribe to. So whoever decided to make this change, get rid of it. So this is really reminds me about stocks and season picking when it comes to stocks. And what I mean by that is, what is the time frame do I buy certain stocks? Well, I believe there is a bit of a formula to this. And in this video, I'm going to talk about that formula. Now, everything really comes back to the macro, the how the economy works, the flow of money. And when we think like that, we can start to see changes in the economic season. And as we experienced back in March, we experienced a cold winter, a freeze in the market, a downturn of 20-some-odd% in the S&P by the March 23rd. And then we had springtime, and that's when the Fed came back with all their money and pumped it into the system. And 20%, I learned this today, this is so mind-boggling, 20% of the U.S. dollars that are in the world today were made in the last year, 20%. That's how much money has been printed over the last year or so. And when that money came back into the system, we had all of a sudden a liquidity overflow, and that's when the market took off. Well, what did well? First of all, technology did well. It was a heavy rebound off the lows. We had a couple other sectors, just really technology and Tesla, right? That's all we heard about. Tesla and Neo, and then Tesla and Neo, and then technology. Well, now we're in a recovery phase. We're in a growth phase where we're seeing growth in the stock market. We're seeing growth in the economy. We're seeing, actually, as of yesterday, the reporting of earnings, there's been a 6% growth rate of all the companies have reported in the last this quarter versus a year ago. 6% growth rates, which is pretty healthy. It's pretty substantial. So the economy is growing. So what will do well in this economy? As you can see, I got my winter hat, but the economy and the inflation element is starting to accelerate. So growth is accelerating, inflation started to accelerate, and of course the Fed is continuing to print money, and they're continuing to keep interest rates low, which makes money cheap, and people are leveraging up, as we've seen throughout the last year, and people are putting more money into risk assets. So what sectors are going to do in this springtime growth period? All right, so the areas that do great in this springtime, things are starting to grow again, atmosphere are commodities, equities, credit, and FX or currency. All right, so in those areas, what is going to do well? Of course, technology. It's changing our world. It's leading the way. I said to my wife the other day, since I don't drive as much as I used to, do you think maybe I should consider getting an electric vehicle? And she looked at me and said, well, why? And I said, well, you know, the environment. I watched a couple of videos on the environment. Elon Musk is pretty cool and he's pretty smart. He must be know something that's coming. So anyhow, technology continues to lead the way, along with consumer discretionary, industrials, and industrials are looking like a good opportunity today. Energy, which I love because it's been so beaten down. Energy prices on companies, on the everything from the guys who, you know, do the exploration to drill the holes, bring it out of the ground, refine it, and then distribute it. They're all have just been annihilated in the last 12 months, and they are really priced right. And as the dollar continues to devalue, I know I rant about this correlation thing, but devaluation of the dollar, which is the opposite reaction to commodities. So your energies, your corns, your coppers, your cows, what have you, lumber. Look at lumber. I mean, a year ago, lumber was at $250 per board feet. Today, it's at $1,000 per board feet. I mean, chances are with everybody moving to Florida and Tennessee and Texas, well, maybe not Texas today because it's freezing in Texas, maybe you're going to see more home construction. I know within 30 miles of me, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 new apartment complexes, 200 plus units and above, going up because of the flood of people moving to Florida. So lumber costs are high, but it's not stopping people from buying homes. And then the other side is financials. Well, financials are do well as the treasury goes up. And as long as the treasury goes up, financials will do well. So pick right when it comes to that kind of thing. So overall, I like these areas, these sectors. I like high beta positions, so stocks that are a little bit more juiced up. They're nitrous oxide in a sense. Beta is a measurement of risk. So if you think of the S&P 500, it has a beta of 1. Anything above 1 takes more bigger return, but it also takes bigger risk. So if the S&P goes up 10%, you have a beta of 1.1, then you're going to go up 11%. But with the market, if the S&P goes down 10% and you have a beta of 1.1, you're going to go down 11%. So there is more risk on the downside, but we're in a upward trending market. So that's why I like higher beta positions. Small cap, of course, they've done really well over the last 6 months, but I still like them. It's innovation, it's companies, technology. You're seeing a lot of small cap companies get in the news here recently, especially because of the whole the network effect that is happening. We're seeing younger people who understand technology, who look in the future. So you're looking at, you know, electric vehicles, alternative energies, those kind of things. Those are the companies that the masses are starting to look at and consider. And because the younger generation, younger than mine, the Y and Z generation, are actually bigger than the baby boomer generation, and they are making money, they're putting that money into stuff they believe in over the next 5 or 10 years. And that's why you're seeing a big boom in electric vehicles. The other side is momentum. We got momentum going. And when you get a mass of people, you get this network effect, also known as the Metcalf's law. And it basically says the value of a network is based on the number of connections that the network has. And if you look at the Wall Street Bets situation, Reddit, Twitter, and how many people are connecting on there and how many people are getting behind stocks they see in the future being high growers, you're seeing more high momentum stocks in that mix. Now, what if you're a conservative investor or a moderate conservative investor or just a moderate? Where are you going with your fixed income side of things? Well, this is where convertibles look good, convertible bonds, preferreds, high yield credit, so high yield junk bond, that kind of thing, and then leveraged loans. So those are areas where we're seeing growth. High yield, definitely people can get into, they understand it. It's more of the junk bond thing. Michael Milken is famous for creating a bond for Sam Walton, who created Walmart. And he would not have been come what he is if it weren't for those high yield or junk bonds that Michael Milken created. Great book back in the 80s. I think it's called Den of Thieves. Great book to read. Gives you understanding how the junk bond market and insider trading sort of came about and became very, very public. So how do you go about finding these companies in these sectors? Well, it's a matter of doing your due diligence and screening. It's a matter of going and picking the sector, say a commodity sector like energy, and going through the different types of companies, understanding the different stages of how oil gets into your gas tank or how it becomes a plastic or so on, gives you a better understanding of the different stages of those companies and where you can invest in those companies. Of course, do your homework. This is just educational, no advice here, just educational, me ranting about how to go about finding companies that are going to run for the next 3 to 6 months or so. See, I only think in 3 to 6 month periods of time, 90 days, 180 days periods of time. And the reason I do that anymore is because the world changes so drastically, and it just makes sense to me. And that's why I'm so like growth oriented, inflation oriented, hawkish on the Fed and monetary policy, and why I believe that markets are going to go higher for the short term, or for at least the next 90 to 180 days. Pardon me, just ate lunch. And so this is where I'm getting aggressive, high beta positions, stocks that are a little bit more risky, but are changing the world, have a purpose, have momentum, and fall into those categories that I just spoke of. I hope this has been helpful for you. Stay warm, America. This is crazy, all this weather. But if you think about it, this weather creates an opportunity. And what opportunity is it creating? It's creating an environment for the demand of energy. So you should be looking for energy companies that will profit from this. A devaluing dollar, because the dollar is at the high end of its trading range. We'll talk about that later. And this creates an opportunity for you to get in, buy solid fundamental companies, do your homework. This is not advice, just education. Anyhow, stay warm, take care, and I'll talk to you soon.